Hello everyone, hi and welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a tutorial on NPV versus XNPV. So, as you can see over here, there is an example of using a formula, this NPV formula, that is discount rate. Then there's value 1, which is cash inflow, and the value 2 will be your cash outflow. It can be either of the thing. But at the end of the day, this is how you prepare the, you work on the NPV formula. In case of XNPV, there's one discount rate, there's one cash inflow and outflow, and there is one date. So let's understand. See, net present value is defined as basically the difference between, you can say NPV is your difference between existing value of the net cash arrivals at the existing value of the total cash expenditures. So NPV is most helpful in the case of periodic cash flows. If you have sort of, you know, periodic cash flows, then this is really very helpful. XNPV, on the other hand, determines the net present value for a range of cash payments that need not essentially be periodic. So the only difference between NPV and XNPV, it's not the only actually, is the periodic and non-periodic in nature. Okay, so this is the difference between NPV and XNPV. So what is NPV? See, net present value is defined as the difference between the existing value of the net cash arrival, that is the present value of the cash outflow, less the present value of the cash inflow. When you have this two, present value of the cash outflow and present value of the cash inflow, PVCI. So if present value of the cash inflow is greater than outflow, that means NPV is positive. NPV is generally used while preparing the capital budgeting estimates for accurately determining the viability of any projects or a prospective investment opportunity. So let's understand the formula of NPV. So as you can see over here, NPV is exactly your total cash outflow and total cash inflow. The difference between that is going to be your NPV, net present value. So this is the total cash inflow for the project, the XT divided by 1 plus RT, because that you are discounting it. Okay, so basically all the your cash inflow has been discounted and you deduct the cash outflow, that is your expenditures. R is your discounting rate, that is WACC, and T is your time period. The formula for determining NPV, when the cash arrivals are uneven, so you have to discount each and every cash flow with the help of the R, and you have to change the N over here as 1, 2, 3. Your R will remain constant, okay, but your cash flow will be unequal in nature, and there will be a cash outflow that you will be deducting it. So here basically R is the specific return rate of per period. C1 is the consolidated cash arrival during the first period, second period, third period, and fourth period, and so on and so forth. Now let's evaluate the project selection using NPV. See, for individual project, take a project simply when NPV is calculated is positive, discard it if project is calculated as negative. So if your NPV is greater than zero, then your project is acceptable. If your NPV is less than zero, then your project should be discarded. So if NPV is equal to zero, then there is indifference point, and there is no way you can decide either of the way. So for completely different projects or competing projects, consider a project having a greater NPV. Okay, net present value with a positive sign signifies that estimated earnings delivered by an investment opportunity or a project, like in existing dollar denomination, surpass the project expenditures and also in existing dollar value. See, usually any investment having positive NPV result is bound to be lucrative, one while having the other negative NPV results would lead to an overall loss. So IDEA particularly defines that net present value rule, indicating that only those investments must be considered that have positive NPV, and negative NPV should be discarded. In addition, suppose the investment opportunity is related to the merger or acquisition, M&A, if that is related to M&A, then in that scenario, one may even employ the method that is known as DCF, that is called discounted cash flow method. So besides NPV formula, the net present value may even be calculated leveraging spreadsheets, table like Microsoft Excel, as well as the NPV calculator. We have already seen how the NPV has been calculated. Let's have a look for one more time. So you can see over here, using NPV in Excel sheet is very easy. The NPV over here, once you enter and use the tab button, you get the formula. The rate over here is a discounting rate. value 1 is usually been taken as your inflows and value 2 is your outflows. Value 1, 2, 3 are the cash inflows and outflow at the end of the 1, 2 and 3 respectively. Now let's understand an NPV example with specified predefined cash inflows. Let's say suppose there is a company and you can say it is keen on analyzing the estimated viability of key projects that demands an early outflow of 20,000 over the 3 years. So 3 years is the time spent. The project seems to deliver revenue of 4,000, 14,000 and 22,000 respectively. The projected discount rate is close enough to 5.5%. At an initial glance, it appears that the investment returns are almost double the initial investment, but the amount earned over the 3 years remains not the same value as the net amount earned today. Hence, the accountant of the company determines the NPV in a unique way for identifying the overall profitability. So, we see the solution over here, the addition of the present value received, deduction. So 4,000, as you can see, there is uneven cash flow, 4,000, 14,000 and 22,000. There are three periods. So 1 plus the discounting rate over here for us is 5.5%. So if you have your discounting rate of 5.5%, so 1 plus 0.055, that is 1 plus R raised to N, that is 1, 2 and 3. And all the cash flows have been discounted. So in this fashion, you have to deduct your cash outflow and you get your NPV as 15,105.3. See, solving NPV problem in Excel are very easy and it is not a big deal in itself. First, we need to put the variables that was a discounting rate, then the value 1 and value 2 as it is given in the formula. So in this example, we are provided with the discount rate of the earlier 5.5%. When we use NPV formula, we start with 4,000 cash flow each. So year 1, 2, 3. So we'll put the cash flow as 4,000, 14,000, 22,000 and 20,000. When we use NPV formula, we start with 4,000 in year 1 and choose the range until 22,000 corresponding to the cash inflow of year 3. Now let's see how Excel thing work. See, you see over here 0, 1, 2 and 3, the cash flows are there. 20,000 is the negative cash flow. Then there is 4,000, 14,000 and 22,000. The discount rate is given over here as 5.5%. So that gives us the present value of the cash flows, NPV. You can see C5. So this is your discounting rate that has been taken, and D3 to F3, that is your cash inflows. So this is your present value of the cash flows of year 1, 2, 3. Now, because this doesn't have to be discounted because it is at zero, you just need to deduct 20,000. So the present value of the cash flow from year 1, 2, 3 is 35,105.3. The cash invested or cash outflow is 20,000. So you deduct the present value of the cash inflow less the present value of the cash outflow, which is your 20,000. So that gives you your net present value. So basically your net present value will be 15,105. Now let's understand NPV example with uniform cash inflow. Let's see that. There is an example. Determine a project of NPV value that needs an early investment worth of, investment is made of 2,45,000. That's your cash outflow. While it is estimated to deliver a cash arrival of 40,000 every year. So there is a uniform payment every month for forthcoming for 12 months. The remaining project value is assumed to be zero. This expected rate of return is 24%, which is our discount rate. So early investment, this is your cash outflow. Overall cash arrival per year, cash inflow. We just have to discount this particular case. Period is how many? 12 months. Discounting rate is basically 24% per annum, which gives us 2% per month. So let's see how the NPV calculation they have made. The NPV calculation is basically 40,000 into 1 minus 1 plus 2, or either you can do directly 40,000 for the span of you can make for 12 months, and then discount the value less the cash outflow, that will give you your net present value. So likewise, we did in earlier example, the first thing we'll do is to put the cash inflows and cash outflow in the standard format as given below. There are some important points that is to be noted, that in this example, we are provided with monthly cash flows, whereas the discounted provided is, you can say, for full year. In NPV formula, we need to ensure that the discount rate and the cash inflows are in the same frequency. If it is not, then that would be really difficult to calculate. Meaning, if we have monthly cash flow, then we should have monthly discount rate. If it is quarterly cash flow, then quarterly discount rate. If it is 6 monthly cash flow, then 6 monthly discount rate. So it should be uniform in that particular case. In our example, we work around discount rate and convert this yearly discount rate into monthly discount rate. So 24% was the discount rate. We have converted that into for monthly. We use 2% as the discount rate. So as you can see, months over here, the cash outflow, and there is cash inflows, which gives the discount rate as 24% and monthly as 12%. Let's go down and see what exactly is the calculation. Using the monthly cash inflows and monthly discount rate of 2%, we calculate the present value of the future cash flows. See, present value of the cash inflow for 1, 2 and 3, NPV, as you can see, C16 is your 2% rate, and D13 to O13 is all your cash inflows for 12 months in total, and you deduct the value of 2,45,000 because this is your present value of the cash inflow, this is your present value of the cash outflow. So your present value of the cash inflow is $423,013 less the present value of the cash outflow, which gives you your NPV. So cash invested or cash outflow in month 0 was 2,04,500. With this, we get the NPV as 178,013. Now let's see things with the help of XNPV. See, what is XNPV? XNPV function is Excel primarily determines the net present value for a range of cash payment that need not be essentially be periodic. So XNPV is your cash inflow divided by 1 plus R, that is your discount rate, then raised to D, that is the expense date, and into D0 divided by 365, that is the date for the 0th expense. So let's see the things, how things have been calculated in Excel. The XNPV function in Excel employs the following formula: rate, value and date. So rate is the discount rate, values that we have the cash inflows and outflows, and the date that we need to input. So value of range, a set of numeric data depicting the income and payments where the positive figures are identified as income and negative figures are identified as payment, which is known as the cash outflow. The first disbursement is discretionary. Okay, you can you if you want to, yes, no, it's fine. It signifies a payment or expense at the start of the investment. And a date range, a range of the date equivalent to the series of expenditure, and the payment error should match with the error of the supplied value. Let's see one example over here so that we get a clear idea. We'll take the same example as we have taken for the NPV above. Suppose a company is analyzing the viability of a project and early outflow is around 20,000 over the 3 years time spent to deliver revenues of 4,000, 14 and 22 uneven cash flows. So dates over here are there for the cash flows, for the uneven cash flows. The discounting rate is there. So the difference, as I told you, is the periodicity. The second step is to calculate providing all the necessary inputs of XNPV. So C5 is your discounting rate. C3 to F3 is your basically your cash inflow, and then C2 to F2. Okay, that is your date. Okay, so we get the present value of using NPV as 1605.7. So with NPV we got the present value as 15,000, and for XNPV we got at 1605.7. So you can see there is a major difference over here. And what is the difference? See, present value using XNPV is higher than NPV. Now can you guess why we get different present value under XNPV and NPV? See, the answer is very simple. NPV assumes that the future cash inflow happens at the end of the year. Let's assume that today is 3rd July 2017. Then the first cash flow of 4,000 is expected to come after 1 year from this date. This means that you get 4,000 on 3rd July 2018, 14,000 on 3rd July 2019, and 22,000 on 3rd July 2020. However, when we calculate the XNPV, the cash inflow dates where the actual year and end dates, where when we use XNPV, we are discounting the first cash flow for a periodic that is less than 1 year. Likewise for other, this results in present value using the XNPV formula to the greater than the NPV formula. So as we have discussed, we have gone through various examples. Now let's understand the various common errors for XNPV and function. See, if the user gets an error while using the XNPV function in Excel, this could fall in either of the mentioned category. Like, you know, there are common error like numerical error, which is called as NUM error. And see over here, the dates or values errors have a different lens. Second, the entered dates might be earlier than the initial date. Third, in some version of Excel, I also got NUM error, that is NUM error, when the discount rate was 0%. So if you change the discount rate to any number other than the 0%, the error go off. So for example, while I worked in above example NPV versus XNPV, I used around close enough to 0.00001% instead of 0 for calculating XNPV. And there is another error that is called as value error. And this occurs due to any mentioned values or the rate arguments could be non-numeric, or any dates provided might not be identified as dates in the Excel sheet. So I hope you have got a clear idea regarding NPV and XNPV. The major difference is just the periodic and non-periodic case.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.